There's our John by some of the trainees in Botswana because they think that's his name. So I said to him, what should I say about Patrick? And he said, you don't need speeches, just have a party.
Yeah.
That's what Patrick would have liked. And I think in a way that's true, but it is nice to have the space to make tributes. I remember Patrick's parties at the Lizzie Pat House, and that's one of the things I loved about Pat. He was serious, he was hardworking, but he loved to party. And that is so important. He even made us drink his horrible beer at He was into, as you know, import substitution. So you weren't allowed to have Castle and Lion. You had to have Patrick's beer. The things also that I loved about Pat was his smile, the most amazing smile. He spoke very quietly. And his sense of humour. He had a really wicked sense of humour. Now, he was special, very special. We all know that. And Sandy Grant, in his obituary, referred to him as a colossus. And I think that's a very, very good description. Patrick was charismatic, visionary, and inspirational. He was committed, as you all know, to social justice, to making education relevant to the needs of local people. And what he achieved in Botswana was astonishing. And that makes a tribute to him difficult, because where do you start? He had three schools, Boiteko, the cooperative, the newspaper, and also the whole philosophy of education for production. Well, through the journal, conferences, seminars. Now, the Institute of Education in the library here downstairs are the journals, Education for Production. So I went down and had a look at them and remembered all those links that Patrick made throughout the world, Papua New Guinea, Grenada in the Caribbean, Zimbabwe, South Africa, here in England, and the producer co-ops in Spain, Mondragon, still going strong. All the links were there in that journal. It was fascinating. And also, I printed out a lovely photograph of Pat, looking very happy on his visit to China in 1985. He even looks a bit Chinese. On the wall of China. I brought it anyway, so you can see. Now, Pat's ideas live on in all of us, in all those he touched in Botswana. And I found a lot of the ways of working that I learned from Pat fantastically useful when I was teaching in challenging inner city schools, and then later when I came here to do teacher education at the Institute. The benefits of working collaboratively. The need for constant discussion to refine your aims and to change things if they didn't work. The democratic structures that he set up to involve students in their own wider learning. Working on development studies, that was a fantastic grounding in curriculum development, making the curriculum relevant to working class pupils. I also want to thank Patrick for making me a socialist. And he lived his socialism. He was uncompromising about the need to redress inequalities and to fight for social justice. And finally, I want to say to Pat, thank you for saving me from a Baptist training college in the Cameroons. Because that's where International Voluntary Service were going to send me. And they realized that somebody like me wouldn't last 10 minutes. So they rang up Pat and said, we've got this dreadful woman, but she does work hard. Will you take her? And he did. So I started there as a young volunteer. And that began my long and fruitful friendship with Patrick. Not only Patrick, but many other people here who've remained really good friends who were inspired by him. Thank you.